So let's say the application, how to display the numbers from 0 to 9 on 7 segment common anode device by using embedded C program with Proteus simulation. So now open your Keil Microvision and select project tab and choose the option new project. Now give your project name and click on save. And this is the window for selection of device from different manufacturers supported by your Keil IDE. Now just I am choosing the manufacturer Atmel, and if you click on this plus mark, it will show the list of devices from Atmel manufacturer, and choose a specific device from Atmel manufacturer. Once you select the device, it will show all the internal features of your microcontroller with the individual quantities of your features. So quantity of your IO lines, quantity of timers, interrupts, and memory availability of on chip. And click on OK. And this is a startup code warning. Just if you want to add this startup code for your device, just click on S, otherwise no, there is no problem without creation of this, no. And to write the program for displaying the numbers from 0 to 9 on 7 segment, just you have to open editor. For that, go file tab and choose the option new. So this is the text editor. Here you can write your embedded C program. So before writing your program, try to save. For that, go file tab and choose the option save. And give your program name with a related name. Now I am giving my file name as 7segment.c. This is my program file name. And after giving your name, just go save. And now you can start. You can write your program. So this is the file name for header file for your all 51 families. And now you can start your main compilation from here. And you have to save your lookup table values for individual numbers. You have to calculate your hexadecimal values of equivalent numbers from 0 to 9. So just I will write down here for equivalent hexadecimal values of numbers, because I am taking array size as 10, because I want to save these 10 numbers with a character data type. And the first value, which is 0xc0, this is the hexadecimal equivalent of the zero number on 7 segment, and these values which are calculated based on common anode. So if it is a common cathode, it should be different, and it's a quite opposite. This is the value for displaying 0 on 7 segment, and for 1, 0xf9, and for 2, 0xa4, and for 3, 0xb0, for 0x99, for 5 0x92, 1460X82 and 70XF8 for 80X80 for 90X90. So these are total 10 numbers which are stored in a segment array. So by passing these hexadecimal values one by one to the IO port, it will display your numbers on 7 segment, which is a common anode 7 segment. And for loop repetition one by one, I will take a character data type X. And if you want to stay some time for every number, just I will take simple for loop delay. For that I will take integer data type I. Now, so these are all the values. So I take in from lookup table, and this is the variable for loop repetition, and this is the variable for loop delay. And I am connecting all these 7 segments with port 1. So this configuration is required as an output. This is the output configuration, and I will activate all the segments which are connected with port 1. And now I am entering into the infinite loop. This is while of 1, which is always true, and now so I will take for loop. So to start the count from 0, and I will compare with 10 because I have numbers from 0 to 9. So I will compare with 10. It will start with 0 and it will repeat your process 10 times. So now for which segment you have to pass this array values? So which are one by one. So by using port 1 0x segment of x, so for x is equal to 0, it will get the first element of your segment array, and which is passed through port 1. And for each number I have to wait some time. So for that I am taking self for loop for 60,000 value and close the for loop statement and close while and close main program. So this is the simple program for displaying 0 to 9 on 7 segment program. And if you want to compile this program, so try to save this program and if you want to run this program on a specific target device, go target 1 and click on this plus mark. It will show source group 1 and right click on it, and you have to choose the option add files to source group 1 and choose your file 7 segment, add and close. So this is a way you can add your program with a target. And so try to save, and if you want to see the errors and warnings of your program, go project tab and click on build target. So now you don't have any errors and warnings for your program. And if you want to see with debug session, go debug tab and choose the option start and stop debug session. And if you want to see these values, whether these values are passing one by one to the IO port or not, go peripherals and choose the IO port feature and select the option port 1. And once you want to execute this thing step by step, you can observe the values from port 1, which is 0xc0, f9, a4, b0, 99, 92, 82, f8, 80. And again, it will repeat your process from c0. So this is the way you can debug your program by using debug session. So if you want to stop debug session, go same option, debug tab, and choose the option start as stop debug. And if you want to see the output of your application with hardware simulation by using Proteus, you have to create hex file. So to create hex file for your embedded C program, select target 1 tab and right click it and choose the option options for target 1, and give your oscillator frequency as 11.0592 and highlight this use on chip ROM option and select your output tab and create hex file and click on OK. And after doing all these options, go save and build it. So now you will get hex file path for your embedded C program. So after completion of your creating hex file, just minimize it and open your hardware simulation tool, which is Proteus. Select the device P and choose your microcontroller, which is 8089C51, and select your other component, which is 7 segment, and you have to choose your 7 segment with a common anode. So this should be common anode 7 segment display. You can go through any one with a single digit. So this 7 segment with a red color, as double click it, it will come into the list. So this 7 segment device, next just place your components on the design tool and choose your 7 segment device and connect your segments with respect to IO lines. This is A segment and B segment, which is connected with P1.1 followed by order P1.2 P1.3 P1.4 P1.5 and P1.6, and this is your common pin you have to connect with VCC. Because it is a common anode, you have to connect this common pin for VCC. So after giving all these hardware connections, just double click on controller. It will ask for program file path and choose your hex file 7segment.hex and give the same oscillator frequency as 11.059. And if you want to see the output, you can play your hardware simulation. It will display 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and again it will start from 0. So this is the program for displaying your 7 segments one by one by using your embedded C program with Keil and Proteus simulation combination. Thank you. So if you want to stop simulation, you can stop by using this stop button.